afternoon. We're here at the Senior Center in Lancaster, Mass. And we are going to have three recipes today. I'm going to show you how I make a vegetarian shepherd pie. And I have a favorite recipe of a friend of mine, and it's a mock chicken pie. And then I'm going to make a corn avocado salad. And it's very simple to do. And I'm just looking over and thinking that we'll get started with making, we have to make some pie dough for the mock chicken pie. And maybe that might be the first thing to do. I have potatoes boiling here, or then almost boiling. And we have to get them right. So I think what we can do is we can make our pastry flour first, okay? And with the pastry flour, I've used several different recipes. Oh, before we get started with that, I wanted to share something with you. I have this beautiful brochure, and it talks about God's healing rainbow. And it's true. We should eat like the rainbow. We should have red, and we should have orange and yellow, and we should have green, and we should have blue, indigo, and violet, too. I remember singing a song when I was little about that. I won't sing it now, but some of the red fruits that we should be eating are apples, red apples, cherries, grapes, lettuce, red leaf lettuce. Don't get the iceberg lettuce because it has no nutritional value whatsoever. Pomegranates, raspberries, red, ruby red grapefruit, tomatoes, cabbage, red cabbage, cranberries, goji berries. I had a friend that ate goji berries, and believe it or not, he had pancreatic cancer, but he was able to live a very long time with that, and that's one of the things he suggested, goji berries. Peppers, red peppers, red potatoes, rhubarb, strawberries, watermelon. I'm just going to read a few off the yellow. That would be papaya, pears, pineapple, yams, squash. Now is the time of year for squash. Nectarines, lemons, peppers, orange peppers, tangerines, and so on. And from the green, well, we are probably familiar with a lot of it. Zucchini, bok choy, celery, fennel, kiwi, okra, peas, chives, broccoli is a good one, asparagus, onions, green onions, spinach, watercress, avocados. We're going to use avocados today in our salad. And the blues, you would have broccoli, purple broccoli, carrots, kelp, that's purple carrots, cauliflower, blue grapes, and blueberries. Blueberries is excellent for you. They say if you consume a lot of blueberries that your memory will be sharp. I should take a whole gallon before I come because I always forget something. Okay, indigo, blackberries, black currants, boysenberries, black beans, black olives, plums, black cherries, black raspberries, prunes. Violet, you have black tomatoes, elderberries, blue mulberries, purple cabbage, purple grapes, purple peppers, and there's several more. So we're going to get started. I just thought I would share that with you. To think about the rainbow while you're eating. Not the rainbow in the sky, but the rainbow vegetables and fruits. Okay, I'm gonna get started with making my, and I may have to wash some things as I go along, but I'm going to make my pastry dough. I used to hate making pastry dough until I realized what I was doing wrong with the pastry dough. And then I was putting too much water in it, and probably should have put a little more flour in it. Maybe that would have solved my problem, but I've been using a lot of flour over the years, so it helps. I'm going to put, in this particular one, I'm going to put 2 3/4 cups of, I used the King Arthur. This is all purpose unbleached. It's very healthy for you. I make all my breads with this. So we're going to put two. And 3/4. So I don't have a 3/4 cup, but I think I have a line in here that'll tell me. So I'm eyeballing it, which I do with everything mostly. So that's about 3/4. If you can see that, it looks like that. And I was just thinking today how much math we do while we're cooking. We couldn't do anything without math, and it's very important. Okay, so I'm going to use 2 sticks of butter. I'm going to be extravagant today. And I'm going to use 3/4 teaspoon of salt. So let me look for my salt. I have it here. 3/4. So I'm using my math now. I'll put 1/2 and 1/4. 1/2, just sprinkle it on there. And let me look and see, my little quarter here is right here. This is perfect. There we go. Now we have our salt. And yeah, ice water is what you use. So I brought ice water with me. And the butter, which you have to use butter in most of these recipes that are not warm temperature, you know, room temperature. So I like to use unsalted butter for the pie crust. I don't think it makes a big difference, but I use it. If I didn't have it, I'd use the other. That's fine. So, okay, let's leave that there. And with this, you have to, you take your butter and you cut it up in small pieces. And I use a knife first, and then I use a fork. That seems to work nicely with me. So I'll cut it up. It's quite hard, and what you could do is just take it in your hand like that and just make small pieces out of it. And then I'm going to need a fork. So I will then, after I cut this up nicely, I'll use it with a fork, and I'll show you what I'll do. And I even use my hands. My hands are clean. And then I will get it all to the point that it's ready for the ice water. Oh, thank you. Okay, thank you. This is a lot of butter, but you don't use it every day. And it has such a nice taste. So for special occasions and holidays, it's not so bad to use it. Since most of the things that I use, if I use a little oil, I use olive oil. So I'm not really using any margarine or anything like that. Wow, I'm making a tower here. So, to take your time with the knife, because you don't want to cut your finger. So, since the butter is a little hard. Okay, so what I do is I cut it up as small as I can possibly make it with the knife. All the big pieces I cut them up. A lot of people make them much, much thicker, but I try to make them a little thinner. It's easier to do, to cut them up. Somebody else may have a better way of doing it. Let me know if you do. We had, on our last program, we had Beth. And she, you know, it's always good to cook with somebody. You can always learn something new. She showed us a different way to cut up certain vegetables that keeps the vegetable together. So never be afraid to learn something new. I guess it's a work of a lifetime to be a cook. You're always learning something new. I still have some big pieces here, which I'm going to try to cut up. Smaller. I don't want to have them too big. All right. That looks, got a big one here. And
This is where your muscles, for me, this is where my muscles come in, because now I'm going to have to break it down even more. Oops, a couple of more big pieces here. Okay. Give it one last try here. Okay, now I'm going to use the fork. And by now it's gotten a little softer. I don't think we should ever try to melt it down, because that wouldn't be good. If you want some exercise, this is what you need to do. Probably should have used a beater, but and they have utensils that you can chop it up, you know, and makes it easier. But not using what's easy today. Couple of big pieces, you know, just working on the side, get rid of them as best you can. I will use my hands later, and once I put the water in it, the ice water, and it'll get that butter all nicely spread out. Okay, now I think I've done enough. I'm going to try. I have some ice in with me. I'm just going to put a little ice in here. And it says use about a quarter or a half a cup of ice water. Now this is about a half. So what I usually do is I use my tablespoon, and I carefully try not to get the ice, if you can help it, and just sprinkle, got the pieces of ice, and just kind of sprinkle it around, a couple of, maybe four tablespoons, and see how it works. Okay, I'll give it another one. Now I'm going to use my hands. It's going to get a little messy, but I find that, I'm just pulling it together like this. And you can see that the butter is beginning to mix in with everything and with the water. There's still not enough water in here, but I'm just going to work it for a few minutes. And your hands get a little messy, so I may have to wash my hands after. It's still too dry, but just work it for a couple of more minutes. And we want to get it so that it's in a nice ball. And I'll probably only use a half of the ball for the topping of the mock pie. I feel as if there's just a few more lumps, but it's not bad. I can feel them kind of separating. Okay, I'm going to put a little more in and try to hold back on the ice. Okay, this might do it. If not, we have to add more water. That's the thing about recipes. Sometimes they don't all come out with the same results. You may have to put less in or more in, or sometimes you have to add flour. That's all part of cooking. Yeah. I may have to add a little bit more water because it is not coming together the way it really should with all this flour. Okay. Get all the dough off me. Okay. Got a piece of ice in there. Oh, okay, now it feels much better. It feels like it's really coming together, and you can almost see it, that it's coming together. Feels good. Sometimes I just take it and I take my hand like that, and, you know, as if you were putting it in a blend, not a blender, but a mixer. That's what those mixers do. They have a big metal device in there, and it just brings all this dough together. I'm doing it the hard way, of course, but yeah, it's coming together. So I'll punch it. If you're mad and angry, don't take it out on people, take it out on the dough. It really is good to work with your hands, though. Okay. Okay. Okay, it seems pretty good now. All right. Okay. I'm just going to break this in half because I have a very small dish. And, no, not. I have that white dish over there, which is this size, and putting that in there. Okay. Oh, I'm just going to leave this aside, and we'll see how our potatoes are doing. Let's see. Oh, they're boiling up. Are they soft enough? They're perfect. They are perfect. I'm going to be making mashed potatoes, so I will leave a few of them in. I'll be carefully taking that out and putting it in another dish. Okay, now our potatoes are almost done, but I'm going to leave a few potatoes on and transfer about 2 small potatoes here. That's what my recipe calls for, 2 large fields. So I'll give it another ladle or 2. But the potatoes here are not quite soft enough for me to put, to make mashed potatoes out of them. So I'm going to put this on, and what I'm going to do is, now that I have my peeled potatoes on, I'm going to put in 2 cans of this, which is, you can buy this at the ABC, and I wanted to mention that anyone who lives near an Adventist book center, because there are people who are looking at this on YouTube, you can go and find an Adventist book center maybe in your area or somewhere near you, and you can purchase these. These are called fried chick. See, they're round, and I'm going to cut these up like this, make them small, little chunks, and I'm also going to add now some of the liquid that is in here. I'm going to add to it some of the liquid. This is a large can. You can buy a small can. And I'm going to put some of it in there. I still have some other liquid left. Because I turned my, turned the heat on, I want to make sure that there's liquid here. We don't want to have something burn. So I'm cutting these up. I'll put several more in here. They look like little small, see, that's what they look like, little small patties. They have a nice taste to them, very nice. And I'm just going to kind of saute some of these things up in here. Okay, doesn't matter really what order you put things in, because we're going to give it a little sauteing, and then we'll put it in the pie crust. Okay, now I'm supposed to put in I can put more in there later if I see there's not enough. An onion. It says a large onion, but I'm using a small onion. I know from past experience, I think it will be just enough if you use a small onion. If you like more onions, use more onion. And we're going to thicken that up in a few minutes. Once I get everything in, we're going to thicken it up with a little cornstarch to make it like a heavier gravy, and a little flour as well. So once I get the skins off of these things, I will be able to cut it up. Okay. All right. You always try to hold your onion like this so that your fingers aren't in the way. You don't want any fingers in your food. So you can cut it up big. I don't mind having big pieces of onion because if you notice, you can notice when you get Chinese food, there's a big pieces of onion in there. They're not little tiny onions. They're mostly big pieces. I like it. Doesn't matter if I have it small pieces or large, but sometimes when I have to do a lot, I just make big pieces. It's easier. So this is not boiling up yet, but I'm going to try to take it all and put it in here. Okay. I hear my potatoes boiling. Okay, so I'm going to put that in. I have now put a lot in here. Oh, two celery stalks. Okay, I didn't bring celery with me, but that's okay. I'm going to put this in instead. Wash it off. And now this, the recipe calls for this. Let me move this out of the way. peppers, either green or red, are quite optional. So I have both, which I'm going to use in another recipe today. So I'm going to use some of both of them today, just a little bit, okay? And see how that goes, since I don't have the celery with me. And, you know, feel free to put in your recipe what you want, you know. I change recipes all the time. So, take the middle part out. And just chop it up nice. I'm not looking to probably cook everything soft or, you know, cook it thoroughly, because you're going to put it in the oven and it's going to cook while you have it in the oven. Okay. I didn't put any salt in here because there's enough salt in the canned product there that you have. If you want to, you can put it on later. All right, so I have to put in now some mixed vegetables. I put some frozen mixed vegetables, and I'm going to put that in there. And then I'll put the whole package. All right. And let me get a spoon. Got the wrong one. Wrong drawer. All right. Just get a spoon and mix it together. I'm going to shut my potatoes off now. This is starting to warm up. So as soon as those vegetables are a little warmed up a little bit, then we're going to put it in our pie dish. Now, there is some liquid here. And so what I'll do is move this over. And I'm going to put, to thicken this up, it's not thick enough for me. I'm going to kind of make a hole here so that I can make it thicker. I'm going to put some flour and a little cornstarch. Cornstarch is great for thickening things. So I have it right here. So I'm going to put a tablespoon or two of the corn starch and flour. I just mixed it together. And then you have to make sure that everything mixes well together. And I might add a little bit more of the gravy from here. And then it makes, see how it makes that kind of gravy-ish? That's what you want. And that'll be very nice once you put it in your dish and you put the pastry on top. You'll have a nice, like a mock chicken pie. Okay. All right. I'm going to get ready to now, I'm going to leave this in here just for a few more minutes. And what I'm going to do is try to roll out the dough. There is your, let's see, maybe I'll use this. Move these things out of the way. And this is not the easiest part, but we're going to wipe the counter because we only want to have the flour on here. I don't want any water on here. Otherwise, we'll have a mess. So we get all the skins from all of our things. I like to clean as I go along. My mother always used to say, a good cook cleans as she goes along. So I'm going to take this and put this over here. Okay. And I'll put that over there too. So now we have a rather clean counter for our dough. I'm probably only going to use this section. I think that's enough. But one of the good things about working with pastry dough, you want to make sure you have your sprinkled flour there so that it doesn't stick together. And I like to do this on the rolling pin to keep it smooth. I don't want to have any sticking. It could stick, but let's see how it goes. My dish is kind of square, so I'm going to try to see if I can not have a lot hanging over the edges. This takes a little work. And you can even still see some of the butter in there that has spread out. Whoops. Yeah, flip it over, keep flipping it over. We will have a nice thick crust for that a dish when I put it in. Something on it. I measure it sometimes, but we could look and see. This has to fit on top. We're not going to put anything on the bottom, but look, it should fit nicely. Should fit very nicely. And you know, we can even take the edges off here and the edges off here, and it'll fit. It'll probably look somewhat more uniform. So I'll take this away, and you know, I have others. Excuse me. I have more, and I have more dough, so I could use it for something else. Not bad. Excuse me. All right, I'm going to put this in here now, carefully. Excuse me. Okay, now we're ready to put the topping on, your pastry topping. And we measured it, so it kind of should look pretty well measured out. I'll just press it down like that, and then we'll be ready to put this in the oven. I have one that I want to show you that is a completed one, and I'm going to put this over here because I'll put it in later, and I will
carefully take the other one out. Okay. This is what it should look like when it's done. I put it in this container. If you have just two people eating a dinner, this is perfect, even for four. You can divide it in four. So you can see the crust. It's not, it's nice and soft and it looks flaky. And so that would be a nice meal with salad. And it's a very hearty dinner for, and this you could even make, if you're having people for holidays that are vegetarian, this is perfect to have, you know, because even if you have it for Thanksgiving or Christmas and you may have a turkey there, this would be a perfect thing for someone who is a vegetarian because they can eat the other vegetables and stuffing and so on with it. And it's a very tasty, tasty meal. Okay, now I'm going to put this with my other dough. I can be using this later on. And we will now make our corn salad. Now, in this corn salad, of course, it's going to be the main ingredient. It's going to be corn. Remember I said I was going to use red pepper? So I'm going to use red pepper. And I'm going to use scallions. And then I'm going to tell you something about this salad when we're done. Okay, get my knife. I'll wash it off a little bit. Okay, I washed my scallions off already before. So what I'm going to do is, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the red pepper, dice it up. Take out the piece here. And you know what's so nice about this? You're going to have a lot of color in it. You're going to have red. You're going to have green. You're going to have yellow. So you have a lot of the rainbow that I was talking about before. You're going to have it in your one dish. And this is a nice little dish that you can make if you're having company and you're not quite sure what to make, or you just... Sometimes you just have people over that that just come for like a little snack kind of thing. So you can have that. Sometimes in our family we have people come over on a Saturday night. We don't want to have a whole meal. So this would be nice to have with crackers or bread or whatever you'd like. So I'm going to put some scallions in. I might take a bunch of scallions, and we can use a good portion of the scallions. We can cut some of it off here and cut the other end of it off. Just look it over and see what you want to use. You know, this has a piece in here I wouldn't want to use, so I'll pull it off here too. I think I'll use one more piece here. Use your judgment, whatever you like. Cut the ends off here. And now we're going to use all ends of it, okay? So I love scallions. Don't be afraid to use the other ends of it where it's just
there's pieces here that are not right, just take them out. If you remember last time, Beth used it in her soup. She used it for garnish. So try not to throw away a lot of these good things, you know? So here we go. Put that in there. I'm going to mix it together. Use all my pieces here. And another ingredient that we're going to use, besides the corn, we'll put the corn in there. We're going to put an avocado. I have a small avocado. You can buy these in the store. And you know, don't, if you're going to use it within a couple of days, then buy a hard one. But this is just a tiny bit soft. Sometimes you don't know what's going to happen when you open an avocado. You don't know what you're going to find inside. Sometimes I find there's little dark pieces. Oh, this looks good. And you just puncture that and you can take it out. You can have your children put that in some dirt and see what grows from it. Okay? So, I'm going to lift it out. My friend has the avocado skins, and what she does with it is she uses it, lets it dry, and she used it for a math game. It's very interesting. I have it too. And so there's a lot of different uses for skins and things like that besides, you know, if you should have a compost pile when you can. Okay, I just did that with my thumb, getting the pieces out. So I'm going to just try to chop it up as neatly as I can. It's a little soft, but it doesn't matter if the little tiny pieces are all over, because we're going to eat it. Gets a little mushy. I'll just throw it in there. This avocados are so healthy for you. Make it a little bigger pieces now, this time. Mix it up a little bit. I'm going to use the whole avocado. Probably if I had used this avocado yesterday, it would have been better than today. It's a little soft, so I'm glad at least I'm using it before anything happens to it. Okay, I'm going to mix it up a little bit. And now I'm going to put some limes. So I got to wash my... knife, and I'm going to squeeze this nice juicy lime and put it in there. I haven't put the corn in yet. I'm getting ready to do that. But I want to make sure that I put this and it can go to the bottom. And it's good to have one of those little juicers. But I did give it a good squeeze. All right, so now I need to have a little bit of olive oil and a half a teaspoon of salt. So I'm going to put a little olive oil, just a little bit in here, okay? Like that, just to give it a little. I don't even have the amount that you're supposed to put in there. And then a half a teaspoon of salt. Let's see where I have my half a teaspoon. One half a teaspoon. Look for my salt over here. Some of these little things, when your hands are wet, it's hard to get it open. Okay, so I'm just going to put a half a teaspoon of salt. That should be good. Okay. last but not least, the corn. So now it has a good flavoring, and we'll add the corn to it. And then we'll have to mix it all. Okay, I'll just mix it up like this. Oops, lost one kernel. Now you can use, Beth was suggesting organic corn. This is not organic corn, and the original recipe calls for canned, but I used frozen. And there you have it. Have a nice, put it in a nice dish. And you know what can be put on top of this? A little cilantro too, if you like it. I love cilantro, cook with it all the time. So here you have your salad. And you'll have your mock pie. You can even have that together. And so I hope you learned something today and enjoy good, healthy cooking. And God bless and be healthy.